Hey, Collider fans, Friday reporting that Filmstruck has struck a deal with Warner Brothers to take on 600 more movies from their back catalog. A lot of classics there. We're going to talk about it next. Hey everyone, John Rocha here with Mark Riley, one of the former champs of the Schmodown. Love so much, love so many films, classic film fan, me as well.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about this news here. Filmstruck, which has been essentially a division of Criterion Collection,
having
like 1,200 movies they have available as a streaming service, about $9 a month. You can see all these incredible classic and foreign films that maybe you don't get access to on other streaming services. They have added 600 more movies.
600?
From the Warner Brothers back catalog. We're talking classics like Singin' in the Rain, Casablanca, Citizen Kane, my favorite film ever, Rebel Without a Cause, The Music Man, Bringing Up Baby, The Thin Man, A Night at the Opera, An American in Paris,
Who's
Afraid of Virginia Woolf. These are incredible classic titles, Mark. What do you think about this?
This is great. And, you know, there are so many options for your dollar out there, right? You got Netflix, you got Hulu, you got Amazon, and you're going to find your general, like, superhero movies, your Jurassic Worlds, your Jurassic Parks, your horrors, and all these things. What I love so much about this is that you finally have a streaming service that is dedicated to Criterion and classic movies. Like, when I was looking to watch It's a Wonderful Life during the holidays, I couldn't find it. I couldn't find where I could get it because I wanted to have that Christmas classic. But this is the place for it. It makes me so happy to know that I can go and watch Casablanca. That's my favorite classic movie of all time.
Wow, yeah. Well, like I said, 1,200 films going now up to 1,800 movies on
Perfect.
There.
Perfect.
And this is an interesting point, Mark. These streaming services now with Disney streaming service,
of course
Netflix had started it, you got Hulu. There's so many streaming services out there. Do you think this is the way of the future, right? This is a great situation as well because now it isn't just about superheroes or, you know, big explosion films, something that Jodie Foster was complaining about a few weeks ago. Now here's your access. If you're a lover of film, to go into this catalog, sign up for this streaming service, and you get more than just the Criterion stuff. Now you get some of these American classics that really have formed the foundation of a lot of people's love of film.
Yeah, this is a nice, an alternative place where you can go for those really diehard film lovers because, as you mentioned, with Jodie Foster saying these things and James Gunn then coming out going, hey, that... We're all artists here doing this, but if you take all of that away, we're all film lovers, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
We're here for a reason. We love films, and a lot of you out there that might be doing a diet of just monster movies, horrors, superheroes, and Star Wars, you want to branch out. You have a place you can go to now, and as the film lover and me, I couldn't be more thrilled to see this. This is the future. Now we finally, not finally, but we have these options to go to enrich our film knowledge. I know for a fact there's going to be a lot of people in my family that grew up with these movies. They're going to look at this because streaming services, it's the wave of the future. It's here to stay, and now we have an option.
Well, and also this thing, it was interesting, their number one request from the Filmstruck subscribers was to have classic Hollywood films
Perfect.
Be there along with the indie stuff, the foreign stuff, art house films, and the cult films. They wanted some more well-rounded stuff. So you get a great idea. So you come out, you could start subscribing to the service and then have a deeper knowledge of film and the technical aspects of film as well. Because I don't know, but I think they do put special features on here as well for some of these films that you can watch, which the Criterion Collections are very much well known for. And there's a lot more coming. I think they're going to see this seeing how people respond, because they're not going to raise the price at this point. They're not saying they're going to raise the price. So we'll see how people respond to it, and how they respond to it will probably be how many more films are going to come on into this service. So this may give Disney a run for its money. This may give Netflix a run for its money for a certain type of film fan, don't you think?
Well, I think it will, and I think it depends on the price point. I'm seeing a $6.99 for subscribers. That's going to go unchanged. You know, are you going to put your money? That's the question. Are you going to put your money towards old classics and cult favorites and indie favorites? This is for, like I said, the grand film lover. So you can get your Netflix and your Netflix originals. You can get your Hulu and TV and whatnot. And you can get your classics and your Criterions. I, for one, am going to put down for this because I think it's worth it. I think it's important that we continue to remember these films and learn from these past films. And hopefully these new young filmmakers are watching these things to make the Star Wars and the Marvels of tomorrow, because you want to have a well-rounded film knowledge. I can't wait for this.
Yeah, Warner Archive did have them available for $9.99 a month. Now with Filmstruck, I think it's $10.99 a month or $99 annually. So you get all the Warner films plus these Criterion films. And I think this means the Warner Archive now, that streaming service goes down, but it just basically gets folded into Filmstruck, which is a great thing. What do you all think about this news? Let us know in the comments section below. Do you like this idea? Are you not going to sign up for Filmstruck? Do you like what Riley and I had to say about it? Or do you want Filmstruck just to be about the art house indie stuff and not get it mixed up with the Hollywood classic films? Let it be its own thing. Let us know down there. Also, remember to like and share this video and to subscribe to the channel. And we'll be back with more Collider videos.